रोहितो मार्गो हेतु दामोदर सह महीधरो महाभाग वेगवान अमिताशन। दिस 40th वर्स ऑफ श्री विष्णु सहस्रनामा गिव्स 10 नेम्स ऑफ महाविष्णु, 6 इन द फर्स्ट लाइन एंड 4 इन द सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ दिस वर्स। Ksharaha means undecaying. Kshara means decay. Kshara means one which perishes. Vikshara is opposite of that, which never decays, which is imperishable. This term Vikshara is often used by those who are meditating upon the Lord in his unmanifested state of glory. All material things are conditioned by time, and all these objects are therefore perishable. The Lord, the Supreme Self, is the subject and is therefore ever unchanging and always imperishable. He is not an object. It can be seen, perceived, comprehended by our five senses. With infinite compassion for the beings, Mahavishnu takes variety of forms. For example, the first of the 10 dashavataras of Mahavishnu is the humble fish, Rohitaha. Rohitaha is a type of fish. It represents fish, also called Meena. This name has come to indicate Lord Vishnu because this was the first incarnation which Mahavishnu took. Meena Avatara of Mahavishnu. When the entire world was submerged in the waters of the deluge and the only living creatures that were available at that time could have been the fishes. So Lord could incarnate at that time only in the form of a fish. Rohitaha therefore means one who manifested to serve the living creatures, manifesting as the fish among the fishes. Such a benevolent Lord takes many forms, but the basic purpose of any form is to show the right path to the devotees. He becomes the path itself. He becomes Marga. He is called Margaha, the path. So God, who is the destination, God, which represents the Paramdhama, he is also the path. So God is the path as well as the destination. That is why they say the means are as important as the end. Whatever you finally want to achieve, but do it in a proper way, because the way is the path. Path also is a manifestation of the Mahavishnu. In order to realize the highest, which is without name, without form, Nirakara, Nirakara Parabrahma, it is Nirnama, without any name, without any form, the human mind has to first hold on, first try to grasp the divine form, that is the Lord Vishnu. He is the way, he is the goal, he is the path, he is the destination. He is the one whom seekers of the highest meditate upon in order to reach the supreme. So they may spend years together, they may spend lifetime together trying to achieve the final objective. But nothing is wasted, because even the journey itself is a very, very pious, valuable, as valuable as the destination. The Supreme is not only the cause for helping devotees, but he is also the supreme cause for the entire universe. Hetuhu. Hetuhu is a cause, is efficient cause, and also the material cause. Efficient cause represents the technology, the know-how, and material cause is the five ma elements, Pantabhutas, together which entire universe is formed. The cause one who is the cause for the whole universe. So he is at the same time, he is the material cause, upadana karana. He is the instrumental cause, nimitta karana. And also he is the efficient cause, the technology, the know-how in creation of this entire universe of beings and non-beings, living, non-living, sthavara, jangama. Everything is the ultimate cause. So he himself is called Hetuhu, and he is the one, and such a person, such a great supreme entity, can be comprehended only by a pure mind. He is Damodaraha. Damodaraha means one who is known through Dhamma. Dhamma is self-control, control of the mind, and other attributes of a pure mind. That means only a pure mind, only a person with a pure mind, self-controlled mind, controlled senses through Dhamma, Shama, only he will be able to comprehend the Supreme. The term has come to indicate the Lord, because he is the one known through the mind, which is purified, udara, by means of self-control, dhamma. Dhamma, udara, damodara. See, this is way this name is defined. Mahabharata calls him, we call him as Damodara, as he is known by means of dhamma. There is one more meaning of Damodara, is we refer to Krishna tied by a cord with his mother, Yashoda. So Yashoda, when naughty boy is creating too much mischief, he wants to make him quiet and sit in a corner. So he ties him with a thread. And the Supreme, who cannot be tied down by anywhere, anything in this entire world, out of his love and affection for his mother, willingly got tied down by a small thread around his waist. Dhamma means a thread. The thread is called Dhamma. Udara, as we know, is the waist. So along the waist, so Damodara is the one who has been tied around his waist by a thread. This term Damodara can also mean one in whose bosom, one in whose belly the entire universe is existing. Such a supreme is all enduring, sahaha. So one example is, as we have seen in this popular name, is the one who willingly got tied down by a thread. So saha is all enduring. The Lord has infinite patience with his beings, after all, who are his children, whether they are good or bad, naughty or mischievous. After all, they are all his children. He readily forgives all the faults of sincere devotees. Why? For that matter, he is prepared to forgive the faults of one of those who antagonize him, who fight with him, who hate him, who try to harm him. Even with such persons, he is all enduring. He has infinite patience. For example, he showed this infinite patience to the cruel and foolish and meaningless words and stupid actions of foolish and evil-minded persons like Jarasandha, Shishupala, Duryodhana. With similar patience, he bears the burden of the entire earth. So he is called Mahidharaha, bearer of the earth. He is a supporter or bearer of the earth. He is the very essence in the universe as its material cause. He is also the one who supports the universe, having made the universe. The Lord supports the world. Support the world can be understood by 2-3 simple examples. For example, the way gold supports the ornaments. There can be no ornaments without the gold. The way cotton supports the cloth. Cloth is made only from cotton. The way ocean supports the waves. Waves arise, subsist, and finally subside into the same ocean. So in a way, their existence is inevitably interlinked with the ocean. So the way gold supports the ornaments, the way cotton supports the cloth, the way ocean supports the waves, similarly, Mahavishnu is supporting the entire universe. There's a saying in Sanskrit which says, Vanani Vishnuhu, Irayo Dishaga Cha Vishnuhu, Vanani Vishnuhu, Irayaha Vishnuhu, Dishaga Vishnuhu. Vishnu is the forests, Vishnu is the mountains, Vishnu is directions, forests, mountains, directions, seas, rivers, the entire universe is supported by Mahavishnu. So he is called Mahidharaha. He is the one who is enduring all the problems which are created by the beings living on the earth. So one who bears the earth is also one who gets the greatest share in every yajnaha, Mahabhagaha. Mahabhagaha has another meaning, ever fortunate. He is extremely fortunate, or he has extreme beauty in all his limbs, or he who is ever fortunate. One more meaning, as we just now saw, is he is the one who gets the greatest share, bhaga, in every yajna, every sacrifice, the oblations which are made, the biggest chunk, lion's share, goes to him, because he is the bhakta, bhorta, prabhu of every yajna. He is also ever ready and swift to come to the rescue of his devotees. Vegavan, one who is the fastest in reaching the devotees. The moment a devotee thinks of him with all sincerity, and the moment the devotee is in need of him, the moment devotee has no other go, Anyadha Sharanam Nasti Tvameva Sharanam Mama. When the devotee says this with his entire being, Mahavishnu appears to him instantaneously. He doesn't take any time whatsoever. Best example we can see is Mahavishnu appearing to rescue Gajendra in Gajendra Moksha. The way he runs, the way he is running from Vaikuntha, even not giving time for Mother Lakshmi or his Garuda or his ornaments like Chakra and Shankhu and Gada, the way he runs to protect, to rescue Gajendra, is something remarkable. So he is called Vegavan. He is also one who is all pervading. Therefore, he is the fastest. Nothing can ever overtake him. Manasojaviya, swifter than the wind, faster than the wind. So now, the dissolution, for example, when we talk of cosmic circle, we talk of creation, sustenance, and dissolution. Dissolution is an integral part of the cosmic circle. So Mahavishnu, who is responsible mainly for sustenance of the universe, has also a role to play in pralaya. Then he swallows the entire world within himself. That means he has tremendous appetite even for swallowing the entire universe. He is called Amitashanaha, limitless appetite. But of course, this is not to be taken literally. It only means the entire world of plurality projected by the mind merges back. When the mind is transcended, when we are able to transcend the mind, the entire universe, which is a projection by the mind, dissolves back into the Supreme Self. So just as we say, the waker swallows the dreamer, the morning swallows the night, the evening swallows the day. Similarly, the higher consciousness swallows the lower consciousness. Higher consciousness, with an infinite appetite, as it were, swallows the entire infinite, so-called, appearing like infinite cosmos. Cosmos is not infinite. Cosmos is finite. The finite cosmos is swallowed by the infinite consciousness. So, figuratively, the Lord is considered to be the great consumer of the whole world of plurality, during pralaya. Now after pralaya, the next phase is once again creation. It is denoted by the first name of the next verse, Udbhavaha, which we'll take up in the next episode. Om Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.